tell us?
It's my birthday.
Happy birthday.
Basically, instead of making that big urn of coffee for people, you're making every cup for the person. So nothing's stale, nothing's old, nothing's off temperature. Everything is made up just for you. Every time that we're doing this, we're making sure that the rough ratio is going to be about 1 gram of coffee for about every 14 or so milliliters of water. Coffee is measured out to the gram for every cup. Hot water is dosed in here. Taking into account for latent heat through the air and the kettle, then we go ahead and we load up these. These are called Harios, these V60 drippers. They're beautiful. The first thing I want to do is I want to create a bloom. And this bloom is just about 60 or so milliliters of water. It can go about as high as 80. What I want to do is I want to make the coffee heavy. So the coffee is giving off large amounts of CO2. Once it's ground and it's been milled, it'll continue to do just that. But I don't want the coffee kind of spinning all over here. I want to give this guy a good cup of coffee. So if I'm going to do that right, I have to make sure that the grounds are going to stay from the bottom. My name is Noel Trepp. We are at XO Roast Co. and I am the Director of Education here. I teach people how to extract coffee differently and about the social process that goes along with it.
Sono troppo stanco.
I understand.
So, what you need?
The nice best.
One cortado.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I certainly threw tantrums, and I definitely, you know, would bawl and weep. It was more of, you know, if I got a new set of Legos, I had to put them together exactly as the instructions dictated. And if I missed a step, I would have to go back and remove the pieces in the order I'd placed them. And I would play with these for, you know, 6, 8, 9 hours. And if you tried to move me away from them, that was when there would be crying. Yeah, people on the autistic spectrum tend to hyper-focus on one, two, sometimes, you know, three different areas. For me, they kind of settled into coffee, for better or for worse. I know more about coffee than I probably should, and far less than I want to. But also literature and music. I remember my childhood like anybody. I think the primary difference is that it's mostly factual. Like, there's really not anything in the way of, there's not a lot of emotion attached to the memory. Like, the memory is just the memory. You were at this place, this occurred, this is what you remember thinking, but it doesn't evoke an emotional response to remember, as it does for some people. That doesn't happen to me at all. I remember there was an instance where I was on a beach. It was probably about 5. It was basically the first time you realize you're a perishable item, so to speak. You know, you can die, and it didn't really bother me. Thinking to myself, oh, this is essentially, if no one finds me, because it was an abandoned beach, it was just, you know, us and like one other family, this is potentially a damaging incident at best. Several things saved me. One, both of my parents being educators and being raised in a family where articulation was highly valued. Two, I presented atypically in that presented lingually
rather than, say, mathematically. I'm certainly not anywhere near a savant when it comes to maths. I never became obsessed with, say, differential equations. I think I'm okay with that. Every morning.